So last time what I was discussing the complement of the number. What was the complement of the number? Complement of the number is, if suppose you want to represent a number that is negative, so your machine, your digital computer can't understand the minus sign. So how you will tell that this is a negative number? So if you want to tell about the negative number, the number that is with the minus sign, so you will use complement. So two general methods I told you. One was the RS complement and second one was the R minus 1S complement. Okay, so both method I told you last time. So I will continue with the subtraction using complement method. So as I said, your machine is very much very good in computing the addition. So what my effort will be, I will make my subtraction operation, I will convert it into the addition. So how I will do this, I will show. So just remember one thing. If suppose your number is m and you are taking the complement, and again you are taking the complement of the complement, it will give you the original number. It will restore the number to its original value. So note down the point. If suppose you have m number, or suppose it is a binary number, I am showing you the example. If suppose I have m number and I am making the complement, and as per the statement what I am saying, the complement of the m means minus m, and again if suppose I am taking the complement of this complement means minus minus m, it will again become a original number m. Okay, so how it is the original number, you can see. So just it is a revision whatever we studied earlier. So here I am showing you the complement calculation using 1s complement method. So what I said, 1s complement method, 1s complement method is just you invert the bit, take bit one by one and invert. If suppose it is 1, you invert to 0. If it is 0, you invert to 1. So for the complement of m, so you see complement of m is actually minus m. If you want to calculate the minus m, you will use a 1s complement of m. So you see here 1s complement of m is actually you converted this 1 to 0, this 0 to 1, 1, 1, 0, 1. So you see here result, it is minus m. Now it is 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1. Okay, so what I calculated here, I calculated minus m. Again, I am saying I will take the complement of this complement. The complement of this complement means minus of this minus m, means complement of m. So what I will do, I will take complement of this number. I will take complement of this number. This is my number, so I will take complement of this number. Again, I will apply 1s complement method. So in this you will do 1s complement of 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1. So what will you get in result? Tell me. What will you get in result if you are taking 1s complement? You just invert this bit. 1s complement, what I said, you invert directly the bit. If it is 0, you invert to 1.
1.
If it is 1, 0. You invert to 0. So just to do it. For all number, all bits. So this is my result. Okay. So this is my result. So what if you are taking again the complement of complement m? You see here the result.
Yeah.
So whatever result m I have taken in the starting, this is my original number. Okay. This is my original number. I started with this m, and when I applied this complement, and again I am taking complement, again what I get, it is same number. Okay, so it is same. So this is the note I wrote here. The complement of the complement restores the number to its original value. Clear? So if suppose someone asks you to prove how complement of complement is original number, so this is the example you can used to explain the things. Now go to the application of this complement methods. What we learned, RS complement and R minus 1S complement. Now I am going to tell you the application of the complement. So as I said, your machine is very much comfortable with the addition. So what we will do, if we want to do the subtraction, so machine cannot do subtraction operation because it can't understand minus sign. So I will use RS complement method to tell the machine that this is my negative number. So see the method. So I am telling you the subtraction operation with RS complement method. So what is the RS complement method subtraction? You just see the steps. So here in the example, I am going to show you the n digit unsigned number. Unsigned number. Okay, so the number as well as we will show the sign. So an unsigned number I will show, and suppose you want to do the operation on m and n. You want to do m minus n, and your base is r, means you are doing subtraction on r number system, rs number system. So what will be the procedure? So what will you do? You will do the r the minus sign minus n. So you know that minus, if you represent f m plus minus n, if you represent this minus n as positive number, so you can suppose minus n is your p, so you have to only do plus operation. So this is the trick to avoid the subtraction. So what here I am doing is, actually I am representing minus n in terms of RS complement. So what I did here, instead of n I am writing r to the power minus n, that is, it is my RS complement of n number. So what we will do, first step is, you have to check the number of digits in m, and you have to check the number of digit in n. Means you will check the number of digit in the minuend, and you will check the number of digit in the subtrahend. For example, if you have m is equal to 1010 and n is 011, so you see how many digits are there, 4, and how many digits are there, 3. So if this is the case, first you have to make the number of digits same. So if it is it has 4 digits, so you have to make 4 digit in n also. So it has 3 digits, so you will add, you will do zeroing. Means you will add some zeros to make the number, make the same number of digit in both m and n. Okay, so first step is, you will do zeroing if number of digits in minuend and subtrahend are not same, right? This is the first step. First you will check the number of digit in the m, minuend and the subtrahend. Second is, if suppose m is greater than n, see, you can't judge that m is greater than n or m is less than n. You will realize whenever you will do operation. So just I am telling you the step so that you will understand why I am applying two different methods on the same subtraction operation. So just you consider the case, two cases are possible, either m is greater than n or m is less than n. So two cases will be possible. So in that case, if your m is greater than n, then your the sum will produce an end carry. So that end carry you will discard, and whatever result you will use as it is, as a final result. Okay, I am repeating, if your m is greater than n, the sum will produce an end carry x. In this case, you will discard that end carry and you will take the result as it is. So we will see in the example. Just you remember the step. This is my second step for the case when your m is greater than n. Another case is, so this is the second step. If your case is m is greater than n, if your m is less than n, then you will follow this step. In that step, your sum will not carry, you will not produce any end carry. So that means your case is n minus m. In that case, you will again take complement of the sum and you will place negative sign in front. Okay, so these are the steps you will use to do subtraction using RS complement method. So let's see the example so that you will understand. So first case I am showing you this. In the example I am showing you this. What I am saying, you just remember, if sum will produce and carry. So what is the indication that M is greater than N? Is if suppose your result will have and carry, that means your M is greater than N. So that will tell you that your M minuend is greater than subtrahend. So that will be indicated by the end carry. The presence of the end carry will indicate you that your minuend is greater than equal to subtrahend. Okay. So what will be the step? You just see. For example, my M is, I am showing you the result, the example of decimal number, because you are very much comfortable with the decimal number. So to explain you the RS complement, I am telling you by taking decimal number system. So this is my M. I am suppose this is my N. So you see here, M is your, this is your M, and this is your N. So as you are very much aware with the decimal number system, so you can directly say that this is the case M is greater than N. So this is the case M is greater than N. So what I said in the beginning, that first step is, what was the first step? Zeroing. Do zeroing if number of digits are not equal in M and N. So you see how many digits are there? 5 and here 4. So what will you do? You will do zeroing. So N number is now your 0, 3, 2, 5, 0. So I added 0 to equalize the number of digits in minuend and the subtrahend. This is my first step. Second step is you will apply the RS complement. You will use RS complement. So what you will use RS complement, as it is decimal number, so your RS complement will be your 10S complement. So how you will calculate the 10S complement? As already you know that 10S complement, the decimal number subtraction. So I will directly do the 10S complement. What was the method? Take number of zeros. How many digits are there? 5 digits. So you will take 5, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you will put 1 here. And then you will write original number. So original number is your 0, 3, 2, 5, 0. And you will do subtraction. This will give you 10S complement of the N. So this is my 10S complement, as because I want to represent my N as minus N, 10S complement of N, or you can say it is minus N. So what will be minus N result? It is 0, 5. It is straightforward decimal subtraction, so you can directly do. So here 0 is less than 2, you will add 10. So this is 10 minus 2, 8. And here you will do minus 1, as you took to borrow, so you will put minus 1. And again it is 0, that is less than 3. So again you will take borrow. So it will become 9. 9 minus 3 is 6. And again as you took borrow, so you will put minus 1 here. Again you will put take borrow. So it will become 10 minus 1 means 9. So this is my 10S complement of N. So that means this is your minus M. So now my task is to do this operation, M plus minus M. So what is M here? M is your 72532, and your minus N is your 96850. So you will add. So you see here, total number of digit in the minuend and subtrahend were 6 for 5, and now you have the carry. That means total number of bit digits are now 6. So this is my carry. So this is the presence of end carry. This is my end carry, and presence of end carry indicates in the RS complement that your M is greater than N. Okay, so this will show you that your M is greater than N. So what will you do? You will discard that carry, discard, and your result will be, your final result will be, final result will be this. So you will discard carry and you will copy the result as it is for the final result. So this is my final result. So this is my final result. Clear? Clear? Everyone clear? Okay, so if you are clear, then you do one example. One example, if you understand. So you do, you apply the same method for binary number system. If you understand, do M minus N. M given is this, N given is this, and then you apply RS complement method. What I said, you just apply and tell me the result. So as I am saying, you apply RS complement, that means you will use 2S complement. To get the minus N, you will use 2S complement. So what was the 2S complement, you remember? 2S complement means, 2S complement of N means 1S complement of N plus 1. Okay. So what will you do? You will do 1S complement of this N and then you will add 1. So if you do NS, the 1S complement, so you see, you just invert these bits. So directly I straightforward inverted 1 to 0, 0 to 1, so you will get this. And then you will add 1. Okay, so you will get this. So you represented your minus N in terms of 2S complement, so this is your number. Now do M minus N. Now tell me the result. If you understand the method previously I explained you, just tell me the result for this, these two numbers. Anyone tell me what will be the result? So I am doing plus operation now. You understand why I am doing plus operation? Because I represented my minus number in terms of plus number by applying complement method. So what will be the result? Tell me the result. So here 0 plus 1 is 1, 0 plus 0 is 0, 1 plus 1 is 1, 0. So I will put 0 here, I will carry forward 1. Again 1 plus 1 is 1, 0. So I will put 1 here and carry forward 1. It is 1 plus 1, 1, 0 plus 1, 1, 1. Again I will carry forward 1. 1 plus 1 is 1, 0. I will put 0 here and carry forward 1. And your result is this. So how many digits are there in the number? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So my result is this. And you will, as carry is coming, so you will discard this carry. So your result will be 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Clear? You will discard, so final result will be this. Everyone clear? RS complement clear? For the case M greater than N, is it clear? Or shall I take more example? So go to the case when your m is less than n. So this is the example. This is the case 2. I'm explaining case 2 when you are using RS complement method to do subtraction. It is a case when your m is less than n. So this is my m and this is my n. So what you will do first, I said you will count the number of digits in subtrahend and minuend, and you will zero in. You will do zeroing. So here 4 digits are there, here 5 digits are there. You will do zeroing and you will equalize the number of digits. So this is my number now. And this time my n is 72532. So you will take complement, 10s complement of the n. So what I said, you to get the 10s complement, simply you will write number of how many digits are there? 5 digits are there. So you will put 0, 5 zeros, and you will put 1, and then you will do subtraction. So it will give you directly the 10s complement. So this is my 10s complement of n. You see, it is 27468, and then you will do addition. N plus minus n, as I said. So I will do 0, 3, 2, 5, 0, 2, 7, 4, 6, 8. 2 addition. It is 8. It is 11. It is 7. It is 10. It is 3. So you see that in this case, 5 digits I had in minuend and subtrahend. In result also I have 5 digits. No carry results here. No carry is present here. That means your case is m is less than n. So you can judge whether m is greater than n or m is less than n by end carry. If end carry is present, that will tell you m is greater than n. If no carry is there, it will tell you that m is less than n. So what will you do in this case? So you will for calculating the final result, you will again take the 10s complement of the result. One more step you have to do to get the final result. What is the additional step? You have to take the 10s complement of the result. So 10s complement of the result is, again you see here 5 digits are there, so I will take 5 zeros and 1, and you will do subtraction. And you will put negative sign. So one more step I am adding here, that if suppose no carry is present, you will do again 10s complement of the result, and you will put negative sign. Put negative sign in front of result. This is my final result. So you see here, this is my final result with negative sign. Okay, so it is negative sign indicates that your subtrahend is greater than minuend. Clear? Subtrahend is greater than minuend. So all step I already wrote in the previous slide. You read it again and then you apply the method in the question. Again, I am telling you the RS complement method for the case m is less than n in binary number system. So same, I am taking the case. See, if suppose m is this, n is this, so you see m is less than n. So you will do 2s complement of n. So what is 2s complement of n is, actually you will do 1s complement. And you will add plus 1. As a result, you will get this. So this is my 2s complement, and then you will add the numbers. M plus complement n. So once you will add, so you will see that this is the case when no carry is coming. See here, in this case, no carry. So what will you do? Again, you will do 2s complement. 2s complement of result. So this is my result. So I will do 2s complement. That means 1s complement plus 1. So this will be 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. This will be my result, and you will put negative sign. So this will be my final result. So same thing I already typed. So this will be my final result. So remember that if your AND carry is not present, you will put a negative sign in front of the 2s complement of the result. Any doubt? Just you see this method and ask if you have any doubt, then I will go to the R minus 1s complement method. There is another, I said R minus 1s complement is also you can use. So what will be the step for the R minus 1s complements? If you want to use this method for doing subtraction operation, so you see you have m minus n, so you will use m plus R minus 1s complement of n. So what was the R minus 1s complement of n? It was R to the power n minus 1 minus n. You know the formula. So here I am showing you the general steps. So the first step is same. You will check the number of digits. If they are not same, then you will do zeroing. And then for the case, if your m is greater than n, so your carry will come. So you will add this carry in the LSB that we did earlier in the 2s complement or RS complement, and you will that carry is called end around carry. That carry is called end around carry. So for RS complement and for R minus 1s complement, your the case m greater than n, the steps are same. Steps are same. But if you are, see here, if your m is less than n, so in this case carry will not come. So carry will indicate that n is greater than m. So what you have to do is you have to do additional step, but in this case you have to take R minus 1s complement of the result and then put negative sign So only the difference is earlier I was doing RS complement, but in this case I will do R minus 1s complement. So if you take the this example, this is the first case. So if you have number, so you do fast and you tell me the result if you understand what I am telling to you. This is m. So I am expecting the result from your side. Apply 1s complement and tell me the result. Everyone do it and your copy notebook and tell me the result. Is it the same? See, everyone is having the same result, whatever I'm showing here, or it is different. everyone tell me my result is right or wrong. Everyone is able to see my screen or not? Just reply me, respond me, please. Whatever result I am showing you, it is correct or not? Is there any mistake? So here I did one mistake. You see, 1 plus 1 is 1, 0. So 1 is carry. 1 plus 1 is 0. 1 carry. 1 plus 1 is 1, 0. Plus 1 is 1, 1. So 1 carry. 1 plus 1 is 1, 0. So here it is, I did wrong. So one more carry and then. So here you see in this case, end carry is present. So what you will do? You will add this carry in the LSB. You will add end carry in the LSB and this will be your final result. Now come to the second case when M is less than N. So use this the step. The number of digits are same, so no zeroing is required. So you can skip the first step. Then you have 1000011. So you will take 1s complement of N. And then you will add. So you see, while addition, you don't have any carry. So no carry is present. So in this case, you will do 1s complement of the result. So you will do 1s complement of the result and you will put minus 1. So now come to the next topic, signed binary number. So till now I was telling you to represent negative number in terms of positive by applying method RS complement or R minus 1S complement. There are other ways to represent the negative number that are called signed binary numbers. So earlier what I was discussing unsigned binary number. Unsigned binary
number. Screen kanapadatale madam.
Screen is not available. Okay, let me share again.
Screen is not visible, man.
Now?
Madam, good afternoon. Man, screen karan parthana.
I think it is now visible.
Yes, madam, visible, madam.
Okay, thank you. So now come to the signed binary number system. Till now what I was telling you the unsigned binary number, that means you are representing negative number in terms of a positive number. You were applying method RS complement or R minus 1S complement method and you were representing negative numbers, right? You are not using minus sign. So now another method is there to tell about the negative numbers, negative sign. So this is called signed binary number method. So what is this? So for example, this is my 76 number and you want to represent this 76. So you will directly represent this 76 in terms of binary. So you can see on my screen. So I am showing you the 76 decimal number system and its equivalent binary number. But if suppose, see here, it is unsigned number. It is unsigned number. So all of the digits that I am using to represent 76, it is only to represent the 76 number. It is not telling you about the plus or minus sign. Clear? So this is my unsigned number. Now I am saying you to tell whether this number is plus or minus. So if you want to represent a plus number, you will use a additional bit. So here, how many bits I am using? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So all 7 bits were used to represent the number 17. But in addition to these 7 bits, I am adding one more bit. That is called sign bit. That is called my sign bit. So if I am using additional one bit to represent my plus or minus sign, for example, I am saying if I am using additional bit as 0, so this is my plus. If I am using 1, that is my minus. So here I am using one additional bit to represent the sign. So that bit is called sign bit. And this sign bit I will use in the MSB. MSB. I will use this additional bit in the MSB side. Okay. So if suppose you are using one additional bit to represent the sign, it is called signed binary number. Clear? It is called signed binary number. So here I am putting this 0 to represent this is plus. If I want to represent next slide, I will show. So here I am showing you the different ways to represent the number. So this, if suppose you are using additional bit, it is a sign. It is showing you the sign and the magnitude. So these 7 bits are representing the magnitude and this is representing the sign. So this is your magnitude and this is your sign. Now again I am writing the number. I am saying this is 1s complement. And I am saying this is 2s complement. So you can see 1s complement and 2s complement. So let me show you how I am representing the negative sign. So if you want to represent the negative sign, what you will do, you will flip all the bits. Means 0 to 1, 1 to 0, you will flip the bits. And 2s complement, you will do 1s complement plus 1 addition. So that already we know. But in this case, what I am showing you here, you will use additional bit and that additional bit will be your 1. If you want to represent the minus 76, you will use these 7 bits are representing your magnitude and this 1 additional bit is representing your minus sign. Sign and magnitude it is representing. So you see, if you are showing the 1s complement, you flip the numbers and you put your sign bit is same. You flip the number and your sign bit is same. You flip the number 1s complement of this 76 and your bit is still, sign bit is still 1. You see, I add it plus 1 as I did earlier, but your sign bit is still 1. So this is the way to represent the negative number. So I am using sign bit and magnitude. Rest bits are representing my magnitude and one bit is representing my sign. So if you want to do the arithmetic addition using signed binary number, so you will take signed and magnitude, both you have to take, and you apply the same straightforward rule whatever we were using earlier for arithmetic addition. So just see the rule. If the signed are the same, so we add the two magnitude and give the sum the common sign. Means if your sign bit are 0 0, you will sign bit you will give the 0 0 sign in the result. If your sign bit is 1 1, you will give 1. So you will not apply addition rule in the sign bit. Is it clear? You will not apply addition rule in the sign bit. You will do addition in the magnitude numbers, but you will not apply addition rule in the sign bit. You will take if the result sign, final sign of the result, if both are same, you will take the same number. If your sign bit for the minuend is 0, subtrahend is 0, you will take sign bit of result 0. Same for the 1 1 case, you will take result 1. If suppose signed are sign bit are different, okay. So if you are you have to check the case. If you are subtract the smaller magnitude from the larger, so you will give the difference. You will give the difference the sign of the larger magnitude. So whatever be the sign of the larger magnitude, it will reflect in the result. So you have to check which result is larger. So rest I will take discuss tomorrow. So this is for all for today. So if you have any doubt in the subtraction using RS or R minus 1S complement, you can ask. If you have any doubt, you can ask, then I will close. Okay, so do practice. I circulated two practice sheets. One is related to the conversion, and another one is related to the simple number system. So you practice sheet 1 and 2, and I will also share with you practice sheet 3. It is related to RS complement, R minus 1S complement. Okay. So if you have doubt, you please ask in the next lecture. So you come out with the doubts so that it will be helpful for you. Okay. So thank you for joining me. So you know that digital electronics is required a lot of practice. It is very easy, but it requires practice. So it is my suggestion, please practice. And if you have doubt, you please ask me. Okay, thank you very much.